Hi, creative people! In this video, we'll show you a new technique you can use to fill free shape with a beautiful gradient. You can use this technique to create and animate logos or dynamic backgrounds. Without further ado, let's dive right in. Starters, let's adjust the working area to our needs and create a background using the free shape tool. For your convenience, keep the size of the free shape smaller than the size of the working area. And we're also gonna keep the shape white for now to make it easier to design the logo. Now, here is the logo we'll be recreating in VSDC. To make sure you don't accidentally select the background and the reference logo, you can lock these layers on the timeline. Okay, it's time to start creating. Select the free shape tool on the left and draw the first element. Feel free to adjust the layer's opacity level at your convenience. Once you're done creating the free shape, select it on the timeline, go to the Properties window, and find Free Shape Settings. First off, we don't need an outline here, so let's select Transparency for the parameter named Pen. Next, find Brush and select Point Gradient. There are several fill modes you can choose from. The default mode is called Hard Light. Let's leave it for now and get back to other options later. Open the free shape with a double click and go to the Properties window. If you select Add Parameters, you can choose what you'd like to work on, the fill or the outline of the free shape. Let's pick Brush Gradient Settings here, and you can adjust them using Color and Weight parameters. Color sets the color of the control point. You can use the eyedropper tool to pick a color. You can also change and animate the color's opacity. The second parameter, weight, defines the intensity of the fill color, and you can animate it as well to create a dynamic gradient. Now pick the desired colors for each control point of the shape, then go back to the main timeline tab and select the free shape layer. Note that you can change fill algorithms. Each algorithm mixes colors differently, so feel free to play around and choose the option that works for you. Repeat your steps as many times as needed. Create new shapes and assign colors to the control points. The logo is ready. We've used 8 free shapes, and 2 of them have a different fill type. It's called Gradient Fill with Alpha Channel. The colors we used for each control point are the colors from the reference logo. The next step is to create animation. Open the free shape with a double click, select the desired control point, and go to the Properties window. Find Weight, click on the 3-dot icon and add a template. Select Sinusoid with a minimum curve value 200, maximum 2000, and frequency 3 Hz. Apply the same effect settings for the necessary points. If the animation for some points doesn't work the way you need, try lowering the value for the weight parameter to 50 or 100. Since we've finished with the logo, let's go to the background layer and unlock it on the timeline. At this step, we'll show you how to fill the background and add animation. Select the background free shape layer, then find the brush parameter and apply point gradient. Open the shape with a double click. Change color values for each control point using the same approach we used for the logo earlier. Next, let's see how to add movement to control points of the shape. Select a control point and make a double click on it. Then select the Add Movement tool. Indicate the direction of the movement with a vector. In our case, we want the point to move around the shape, so we'll need to place several vectors. Repeat these steps as many times as needed. You'll need to apply the add movement effect for each point. If there are areas where the free shape doesn't fully cover the workspace, adjust the movement trajectory. And last touch, select soft light for the fill mode. Now both the background and the logo are ready. To achieve a different result, you may want to play around with the transparency animation and add more layers. That's all for today. Thank you for watching, and feel free to leave your questions in the comments below. Until next time.